The drill string is composed of a drill bit and then a bottom hole assembly and then drill pipes. And the bottom hole assembly is composed of the drill bit, stabilizer units, which are just the right size to go in the hole, and the big heavy drill collars, which you can see just over here. This drill bit here is one designed just to make an open hole, not for coring. And the drilling mud, which cools the drill bit and takes the cuttings away, comes out of the holes. It takes the heat and the rock cuttings away from the cutting face and takes them back up the outside of the drill string back to the surface. And it has these little buttons on it of hardened material which cut the rock. This piece here is designed to keep it nice and central in the hole that it's created. It's called a stabilizer. This bit here is a drill bit which has drilled a bit more than 100 meters, and you can see how it's worn away these buttons and worn away the face of the drill bit. These big heavy pipes are the drill collars, and they go just above the drill bit and provide the weight which helps to cut the rock. This one here has a stabilizer on it, which is a slightly wider part of the drill collar which keeps it nice and central in the hole. And these pipes weigh about 6 tons. This pipe here is one of the drilling pipes, and you can see there's a big rack of them, and these go all the way up to the surface, and these are what connect up to the head of the drill rig, which drives this drilling process. Although this big steel pipe here looks very rigid, when you have 400 meters of steel pipe like this and you put it and you squeeze it, it will actually bend like spaghetti. And so the basic idea of the drilling process is to try and keep these pipes nice and straight by keeping them in tension, and to let these really heavy, stiff pipes at the bottom do the work in terms of providing weight for drilling.